Hi students, it's Shayna from EspressoEnglish.net, and today we're going to talk about the differences between the words review and revise. This can be super confusing because they're used slightly differently in American English versus British English. But by the end of this lesson, you'll understand clearly when to use each one. There are so many confusing words like this in the English language, and that's why I wrote a book about them. It's called 600 Plus Confusing English Words Explained, and everything inside it comes from questions asked by students like you. So if you have a question about a pair of confusing words, you'll probably find the answer and explanation inside this ebook. You can click on the link in the video description to learn more about it and download it. All right, let's begin with the word review. It has a couple different uses. One is when you take something you previously learned and you study it again. For example, if there's a big final exam at the end of the semester, you would spend a few days reviewing everything you learned during the semester. Or if you have a big presentation to give and you've previously prepared some notes, then a few minutes before the presentation, you might review the notes to remind yourself of the main details you want to cover in your presentation. The action of reviewing helps bring things back to your mind. It helps you remember better. Another way we use review is a little more general. It's used beyond the specific context of studying, and that is to look back on past things, consider them, and maybe evaluate or analyze them. So at the end of the year, a lot of people like to review all the events that happened. So we think about these past events. Maybe we consider whether they were good or bad and how they affected us. At work, managers often give employees a performance review. This means the manager considers the employee's past work in general and identifies some strong points, weak points, and things to improve or change. That's a performance review, and it's typically done once a year. When it comes to movies, books, music, theater, and things like that, there are people who review or write reviews of these artistic productions, meaning they watch or read, and then they reflect, describe, and analyze the movie, play, or book. So you'll often hear people say, "That book got great reviews," if a lot of people have written positive observations of it. Okay, so review is used for studying something again to remind yourself of it, as well as for looking back and reflecting on something in order to evaluate it. Now let's look at revise. If we revise a text, it means we make changes, adjustments, or improvements to it. If I write an article, the first draft, that's the first version of my article, might be okay, but not great. So later, I would revise it. I'd make changes to it and improve it so that it can become better. You can also revise plans or procedures. Maybe your company starts using a new technology, so you need to update or revise the procedures at work. You can also revise an estimate or projection. So if you had predicted that sales would be $50 million for the year, but then the economy goes badly, so fewer people are buying things, then you might need to revise that projection, change it, and make it lower. Scientists often revise their theories as new information is discovered. So when we find out something new, we change or adjust the theory. We revise it. So in American English, when we review something, we only look back at it and think about it. But when we revise something, then we change it to make it better. However, in British English, the word revise is also used for studying something again. In American English, we would always say review for a test or review for an exam. But in British English, you could say revise for a test or revise for an exam. Again, that use of revise to mean study again is specific to British English. Let me know if you have any further questions about revise and review. And again, make sure to check out my 600 plus Confusing English Words Explained ebook to get lots of clear answers and examples for words like these. It will really help you understand the English language better and use the correct words more confidently. Thanks so much for watching today's lesson. Be sure to share it if it helped you, and I'll talk to you next time.